Hello students, today I will explain exercise 7B, which is measuring perspective method B. Now last class I explained measuring perspective method A. Now this method is another method, another way of drawing in perspective in a correct way by measuring. So these two methods, method A and method B, are very, very important. Very important in all your drawings in the future. Now, I will go over method B. We will draw again an object, this object. Again, like last class when I explained method A. This is the object that you will have to draw for your homework. So, this shape exactly. Okay, you must draw for the homework. So, pay attention to the measurements and everything. And I will go step by step again by drawing it and explaining this method, step by step. So, we have here again a big cube. The big cube is this time it's 2 cm by 2 cm by 2, okay? The small cubes are 1 cm by 1 cm. And we have to draw this object using this method in scale 1:1. So on the paper, the big cube will be 2 cm and the small cube 1 cm, because we are drawing it in its real size. Okay, so now method B again. You have to be very careful how you set up your drawing. Any mistake in the setup, your drawing will be wrong. So you have to be extra careful. And like in method A, I provided you in the syllabus with helping steps, okay? Because now we have a lot of points, a lot of lines, and it's very easy to miss something. So again, I will follow step by step, and each point I read it out, I will draw it here on the board. So you understand what it is and how to approach this drawing. Okay, now, before I start, just a quick note. Why do we have, this measuring perspective, several methods? You know, why not just one method? Because in design, sometimes, depending on what you are drawing, okay? Sometimes it's easier to use method A. Sometimes it's easier to use method B. It depends on what you are drawing and which method you're comfortable with. So, this is an extra advantage. You have more than one method to draw in perspective with high accuracy. Okay, now let's start point by point and see how this method is applied in reality. Now, the first point, it says here, draw the picture plane line. So this is a new type of line we didn't have before. Before we heard of horizon line, ground line, but this is a new type, okay? Picture plane line. Let's draw a line. Okay, and we will call this line PP. From picture plane. The second step, above the picture plane line, draw the object using the object, what object? This object that I'm giving you, using correct measurements, real or scaled. Now, this object, I want you to draw it with real measurements, scale 1:1. But sometimes, if it's the object you're drawing is too big, you have to scale it down, make it smaller, okay? So it can be real or scaled measurements used here. You have to draw it what? As top view. Top view. So you have to draw this object from the top. You already know what is a top view. When we took the orthographic drawing, you already know how to draw object from the top. Okay, and I will do it here also to show you. Okay, where were we? I'll stop you. Okay, rotate it by 60 degrees from the left and 30 degrees from the right. So I have to draw this as from the top view, but it has to be rotated here 30 degrees and from here 60 degrees. And in this point here, in this point, it will be 90 degrees. Okay? So let me draw this from the top. So we need to start on the picture plane line. So the first point you put is this point, which is this point. Okay? Now, where you put it, it doesn't matter, okay? Just make sure that your drawing fits into the paper in the end. So, please be careful, okay? Measure exact. So, from this side, make it 30 degree. From this side, 60 degree. And here, this angle will be 90 degree, okay? Now, we have to draw this in the top view. So, I will do that from the top. Let me put this here aside. Okay, so now let me check. Okay, so this is the big cube, okay, from the top, this one, this surface. Then we have another surface visible from the top. In the middle, we have a small cube. Then we have two cubes next to it. And we have one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four small cubes from this side. Now the heights, you know the heights, we don't see them from the top. We don't know how high it is. Later we will see it in the drawing. So from the top I see only this surface and this surface and this surface and what is remaining of this surface, this one, and this. And it is drawn as flat, you already know that. Okay, so this is our top view. Now, let's see what else should we do. Draw the 90 degree intersecting lines down from the picture plane line, okay, naming the point SP and the other two points on the picture plane as P1 and P2. So we have two points on the picture plane line, and then we have a 90 degree intersecting point that we will call SP or station point. This is similar to the first method, to method A. We had also a 90 degree intersecting point and we named it station point. So this is similar, okay? Now, just make sure that for your drawing to be successful, so put a line from this point down, just a straight line. Make sure that SP, the point, which is supposed to be 90 degrees, is on this line. What I mean is don't put it here or at the side. Make sure it goes exactly under this point here, okay? So SP can be anywhere here now, but this line and this line should make here, what, 90 degrees. 90 degrees. So let me draw. So these two points we will call P1 and P2. And this is our SP, which is at what, 90 degree. Okay, now, and this SP point lays exactly under on this line that goes straight down from the starting point where you started your drawing. Just to make sure your drawing is organized and, to be more successful. Okay. Let us continue with the next step. So what should we do now? Okay. Select a location below the SP. So under, below the SP, here somewhere, okay, to draw the horizon line. So now we are drawing the horizon line. Until now, okay, we don't have. So we have to select somewhere here, somewhere in this space, to draw our horizon line. Where? Now it will depend on, you know, how much space you have in the paper. You have to be careful with the spacings. There is no particular rule I can tell you to follow. Just be careful, for example, not to put the horizon line too low, because later you have other things to draw below the horizon line and there might not be space. So I will put it really close to the to this point, close, a little bit under, okay? So this, we name it horizon. This is our horizon line. Okay. Draw the ground line. So this is the next point. Draw the ground line. So we have yet another line. We have picture plane line, horizon line, and we will have a ground line now. So the ground line must be below the horizon line. Okay? Leaving what sufficient space for your drawing. So please do not put the ground line really close to the horizon line, because your drawing, maybe this space won't be enough. Okay, so make sure this space is enough. So if I put the ground line here, this space should be enough for this drawing. Okay, not to go above the horizon line. No, it's not a mistake. If, for example, I put the ground line here and I do my drawing here, and some of the objects, because they're very high, they go above the horizon line, no big deal. But not to, visually mess up your drawing, at least not now, because you're just beginning to apply this method. So keep it organized, keep it visually more organized, so we don't have object above the lines and these kind of things. Now, so the ground line below the horizon line to leave and leave sufficient space here. So I will put it down. Be what? The ground line. We need to name each line, each point, so that we get used to the method and we don't confuse, you know, a line, like you might confuse, this is, for example, this is the horizon line, or this. We need to know which line, each line has a different function. Okay, draw the ground line, okay, we did it. Now, from P1 and P2, draw vertical lines, straight vertical lines, down, intersecting the horizon line. Mark the points as VP1 and VP2. So we have to draw from this point, straight lines down. Straight lines down, and where they intersect the horizon line. This will be our vanishing point 1 and vanishing point 2. Let me just check the video if it's recording. Okay, so this seems okay. Okay, so now we have our vanishing points. These are not vanishing points, okay? Don't confuse them. Okay. Okay, what's the next point for us to do? Put a vertical line down from the first edge point, touching the picture plane line, this edge point, okay? Straight down to the ground line. Now, I already started, you know, with this because I needed to find the SP to be on this line. But when we continue down, make sure it touches the ground line, okay? So, all the way, a straight vertical line, and you have this point. Now here, we will start drawing this object in perspective, okay? Exactly from this point. Okay, and this perspective view will be basically rotated at 30, 60 degrees. So in the future, when you get used to this method, you can change these, okay? You can change these. It doesn't have to be here always 30 and here 60, okay? I can put 30 here and here 60, or another measurements, okay? So, but to start off with, you must follow exactly what I say until you learn the method. Then you can play around. Okay, so we have this point, this edge point is the same like this edge point. From here, we will start drawing. Let me see what I wrote here, okay, and the points so that you understand. Okay, so from the ground line, from this ground line, measure the first edge of your object and draw it. And then we will take the edge points to the vanishing point. So, now we need to draw here the first edge of our object, which is this one, this edge here. Now, this is 2 centimeters, okay? Let me use another pen. So, let's draw the first line here. You know, I will make it high because I don't know how much I will need. Let's mark, put the rulers. So, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3. Now, in your drawing, it will be exact. Here, I'm just, you know, by my eye, you know, this should be exactly one, okay, in your drawing. Make sure the measurements are perfect. Even when you draw this object here on the top. So this here should be 2 centimeter by 2 by 2. This should be 1, 1, 1, and this 1, 1, 1, 1, okay? Be very careful not to make mistake. Any mistake here, later when we draw this, it will also be wrong here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so on, okay? But I think this is enough. Okay, so the first edge from here to here, 2 centimeters. So here, it stops from here to here. So from this point, we will take to the vanishing points. Okay, now, let's see what it says is our next step in the paper. Let me see. Okay, where was this point? Now I know what to do, but, okay. Okay, well, I cannot find where I was. Oh, okay. Yes. Okay. Now start connecting some of the corner points of the object. These corner points, do you see this? All of these are corner points, okay? Of the object that you drew in top view, this one here, with SP, using straight and light lines. Okay, all of these are construction lines, so light. Now, from each of these points, I have to draw a straight line connecting to this point. Let me use another color, the green maybe. Okay. So, now, before that, pay attention to something. Now there are a lot of corners here. All of this corner, all of these are corners. You don't need them all, you don't need. And don't connect everything straight away. I will connect only the points starting on the first row. This point, to know the location of these objects on this line. So where does this cube stop? Where is the next one? Where is the other? Okay? To know where I should draw them here. Now, also, this point and this point I will need for the start, and I will need this cube in the middle. I need to know where its location is, okay? So I will need the points also to put them down. After, when I start drawing here, if you see the need that you need to find another point from the points at the back, then you will also take them to SP, okay? So let us start with a few points, because in reality, when you draw an object, it will not be that simple always, okay? It might be very complicated with a lot of points. And if you take all the points to SP, it will be so overcrowded here. So be careful. And very light lines, okay, when you do it. And if you want to dot it, you can make. So, from this point to SP. This point is already connected, okay? We don't need only this point. And this point. And for this side, okay. We need also these corners, the cube in the middle. Just so we can see it a little clear. Now this cube, the one in the middle, I just took from this point and this point and this point, because sometimes this is enough to find the location of this point. So I don't need to, the ones at the back, you don't always need them, okay? Okay, so we connected the points that we want, the corners. Now what? So in our paper, we should have the next step. So, the lines, which lines these, okay, will intersect the picture plane line at certain points. So, these lines will intersect the picture plane line at certain points. So, this line, where does it intersect? Here, this line here, this here. You need to mark them, okay, to see them exactly where they are. Then what? From these points, which points? These, okay, here. Put vertical lines down to your object, on the ground line, to this here object. To find the correct location of the lines that go to VP1 and VP2, and then you construct your object. Okay, so what do you need to do now? From each of these points, straight lines down to the object. You see the first corner, the second corner, we took to the vanishing points. We need to see where these points will intersect this line, okay? So, make sure they are perfect vertical. So you need to draw with the ruler and be very careful, because it's very easy to shift lines. Like, for example, instead of drawing vertical, to draw a little bit at an angle. Okay, it will make a very big mistake here in the drawing. Be careful. So, let us put it down now, each line. So my lines are in no way perfect. They should be straight vertical. Okay. Actually, this here I don't need it now. So this why I don't need it now, this line, because this is for this object. Later I will draw it. I need only to know this point. Did we take it down? Yes. Okay. This, and this, and this, and this. Okay, so this one here. Ends here, and this. This drawing, even the slightest mistake with parts of the millimeter, it will destroy the result here. Even a small shift, okay? If you make, the result will not be good. Because as you can see, they're so close to each other, okay? So be very careful to have them straight. Okay, now, so, this point, okay, which crosses the picture plane line here. When I put a straight line down, it touches here. This is the end of my, this line here, of the big cube, okay? So we have this edge, this is this edge. So this here is this edge. This is complete. Now, look at this point here, okay? It touches the picture plane line here. When we took it down, it touched this line here. So, this here is the end of the other side, this line. Okay? Now, from this point and this point, we will take to the vanishing points again. Okay. So our big cube, this one, is complete. Now, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 small cubes, 1 by 1 centimeter. And already, look, we took the lines down, down, down from these corners. So we know their locations here. So the first cube will end somewhere here, actually exactly here, the second here, the third here, and the fourth here. Now, what about, we know where they will end, but what about the height? From where the height? Again, from the first edge. Do you see this first edge? So, they are 1 centimeter by 1 by 1. So, This is here, 1 centimeter. We will take to the vanishing point. To the vanishing point. So each of these lines should stop at this intersection, okay? At this intersection. Now, to find out these lines here, okay, we need to take each of these points where? To the vanishing point, to the other vanishing point. Okay, so let's do that. I will not complete, okay, because not to overload with lines. So this goes to the vanishing point, this to the vanishing point, and this go to the vanishing point. Okay, now, how do I know, let me remove this so it doesn't confuse you, this is not the end of the small cubes. This line is what? The 2 centimeter height of the big cube, okay, so don't get confused here. Let me delete it. So, how can we know where the small cubes should end? Where is the end of them? Here or here or here, where? Okay, so we need to go back to this. And we need to take a new corner down. So, if I take this corner down to SP and find its location here, that would be great. I would know where they will end. I will not need this or this or this. Just one I need, okay? So, let's do that. So, this corner we will take to SP. So, this line, where does it intersect the picture plane line? Here. Here. Okay, so let's take it down. Tells me that my cube should end here at this point. Okay? Now it's very easy. From this point, okay, all this line to the vanishing point. And it will tell you where the cubes should end. Look, we just needed one corner. And when we take it to the vanishing point, it already intersects this and this and this. So you don't need all of them, okay, at the back. As I said. Okay. Now, let me, okay, delete this line. So we don't get visually, you know, overcrowded, confused. Okay. Now, what else do we have to do here? We have here a small cube that ends where? In this point. We know it because look, this edge point, we took it to SP and then, let me see what, okay. There is a small here problem, okay. So this point, we took it to SP. It intersected the picture plane line in this point here. So from this point we have to put down. And it tells me that it will intersect this line at this point. So this is the edge, this edge here, okay? This edge. Now, of course, it will be higher because we have a lot of small cubes on top of each other, okay? Now, how high it will be, later we will find out. Later we will find out. First of all, let's go step by step. So, we have a small cube here. Do you see this line? This should end, start at 1 centimeter. So, start at 1 centimeter, take to the vanishing point. should go to the vanishing point. So this line here is this line. Now, the second line, we already did it. This is the second line, okay? We already did it when we draw the big cube, because they are on the same height. Okay. Now, then we have another cube, and how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 centimeters, all of this. Let me see, 1, 2, 3. Now 3, we will take also to the vanishing point. 4 to the vanishing point. 5 to the vanishing point. From this line, I need to take also a straight line up. Why? It's the edge of this cube here, this one here. This line, okay? So, this is this line. Now, we already took from the first edge. This is 1 centimeter, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we know the heights. So this line gets intersected here, and here, and here, and here, and here, and here. To know the heights of our cubes. Okay, we also need a line to make it up from here. Okay, so they will intersect here and here and here and here. Now, from these points, because look, where are they located, the small cubes? Next to the big cube. So this edge here is very important. So, we have here the intersections, great. Now we will take them to the vanishing point. Okay. And from this point also. This point here also to the vanishing point. Now, this upper surface, do you see this upper surface? Where is it located here? It's this one. Okay, we already found out where it's located. So, okay, we have another problem. What other problem? This is here. These are two cubes, you know, so we need to know this line and this line, how to find it. Is it located here or here? We don't know. Don't confuse with the first edge, you know, because sometimes lines can be like on top of each other, and you might confuse a line with another line, okay? So here we still have not found this line. How can we find it? We have to go back to this drawing. So, if we find this point, okay, where it's located here, then it will be very easy to take it to the vanishing point and to know this line where it's located. So we don't need this point, we just need this point, which is closer to us. Okay, so this point to SP. So do you see they're very, very close to each other? Very close, so in your drawing be very careful, okay? So it's somewhere here that it touched. So if I put this down, this line, so they're so close to each other here you can't even see them because of the pins. So in your drawing be very careful not to confuse. So this line, when I put it to SP, and then where it intersects the picture plane line, I put a straight down, and it touched this line here, okay, in this point. Now, this point, I can take it to the vanishing point, and it tells me that this line, which is this line, okay, should be located in this place. Great. Now, what about this line? We already have it. because this point intersects this here. So if I take it down, so this line is now this line here. So we have what? Small cube here, small cube, small cube, small cube, small cube, small cube, and so on. And how much are they? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, I made an extra. I made it 6 cubes high. Okay, so this here is an extra. I put an extra 2 here on top by some. I kind of not saw it. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We should have stopped here. It's easy to fix. It's easy to fix. So from this point to the vanishing point, you could have taken, and this from this point to the vanishing point, and the same thing you will find out. So just these 2 cubes without them. Okay, the upper 2, but the shape's the same. Okay, now we still have objects to draw. What objects? This small cube, and this cube. Let me just check the video if it's recording. Okay. Now, this cube and this cube, they are on top where? They're on top here and here. Now, this is very easy. We don't need these points to draw them, because when I put a small cube here, it will be on the same height like the big cube. So let me take this line to the vanishing point. This line, okay, to the vanishing point. Now, I will put lines up. A line up from here, and a line up from here. This will be this surface. Wait. I made a mistake, I put it here. No, this here is next to the big cube. So I have to put a line up from here to touch this line, okay? At this point. So this surface will be this here. Now, we have a free space, and then we have another cube. Also, I will put line up and close it. Let me delete this at the back so we don't get confused. Okay. Now, from this point to the vanishing point, I will not finish it, not to overcrowd. Okay, and from this here, from this and this point, again to the vanishing point, now, so we should have a cube here and a cube here, but how do we know where they end? How do we know where this line and this line is located? Now, they will be on one line going to the vanishing point, but where to stop? You know, where to stop here? We can see if we have a point. Okay. We don't need points, we don't need, because we already found this point, but here it looks like I deleted it, so let me check this point, we already found it or not, here, where is it located? So it's located here, this point. Do you see this point's very important? Okay, so this is the end, this is the line at the end. Now, from here, if I take to the vanishing point, this line, I will know where this line should be up. Where it intersects this line, and this line also should be up. So they will intersect. And this should also go to the vanishing point. So it's here a little bit confusing because there are a lot of lines from behind, and the pens are very heavy, so we don't see. But this is our cube. Hmm? And let me delete the back line, so the hidden line, so you don't get confused again. Let me get another pen. I just deleted some of the back lines so you can see the cube, the small cube, okay? This one here. Here we already started the other small cube. Now, where should it end? This line. It's the same line. Okay, so this line, when we take it to the vanishing point and continue, so it's part of the same line. Now, from this corner to the vanishing point, so this is our line, and from this point to this point, so this is our small cube. Let me delete this at the back, so you don't, it doesn't overcrowd. Okay. So, the small cube on top of this, another small cube on top. Here we have space. Everything looks fine. Now, we didn't draw this cube. This one in the middle, where? On this surface. Do you see this surface? So, we have a small cube here in the middle. How to draw, how to know where to put the 4 points. So we have to go back to here. So these 3 points are very important. Now I already did them. So this point, where is it located? This to SP here, and this down. So it will be located somewhere here. Okay, now, from this point also to SP, and then where it touches the picture plane line down. Oh, okay. So it will be behind the red line somewhere here. Okay. And this corner, where is this corner going to be located? Again, here, this down. So somewhere on this line here. So we will have somewhere here and here and here. Okay. But we have another problem before we can find the points. The problem is that this is in the middle of the big cube, of the surface. So we need to find the locations. Okay. This point and this point. We know they're going to be somewhere on these lines. But where are they going to be on these lines, you know, that go to the vanishing point? So, we need to locate them on this line first. This is very important, on this line here. Do you see? I need to know where this and this is here as measurement. So here or here or where, okay? So to do that, we need to do, we can do the following. So from here, do you see here the cube? Pay attention because it's important. Here, here, here. Now, if I extend the line and I extend this line, it will form 2 points here. Look, this point and this point. It will touch this line here and here. Now, these 2 points, if we take them to SP, okay, so this point we will take to SP, and this point I will take to SP. It will intersect the picture plane line here and here. So, from this point, we will put straight lines down. So, it will intersect this line here. This point here. We'll intersect this line here. Okay, great. Now, this line and this line, where do they intersect this line? Here and here. Now, from these 2 points, we will take them to the vanishing point, okay? this point to the vanishing point, and this point to the vanishing point. Now, the lines that we put down from this corner, again, where is it located, this one? Here. So, it touches this line here. This is very important. Now, I don't even need this point, because when I take this point to the vanishing point, it already tells me where this is located. Okay, now, this here point, where is it located? Here. Now, I don't need to know this point, because this point I will take it to the vanishing point, and I already have this surface here. This surface is the lower surface of the cube. Okay, now how do I find the height of this cube? All this problem with this cube is because it's in the middle, so we have to always find the locations of points on this line and this line, then take them up, then to the vanishing points to find the location of this cube. So it's an additional difficulty, okay? Even now with the heights, when we have to find the heights, we have to find the height on these two lines first, then take to the vanishing points to find the height of the cube where it will intersect. So, I will put like a few lines up for now, but I don't know the height, okay, of this. So I don't know the height. I put this line, and this line up. But I don't know the height. So what should I do? It's 1 centimeter high. So from the first edge, this is 1, 2 for the big cube. Add 1. Now, from here to the vanishing point, this is in the beginning the height. So if I put from this point now up, and from this point up, it will intersect this line here and here. Let me make it red so you can see it. Here and here. Now, from these two points, if I take it to the vanishing point, it should intersect this line and this line at somewhere. So, this to the vanishing point, this to the vanishing point. So, it intersects here and here. Now, our cube is getting finished. So, this here is known. Let me draw it with red so you can see it, hopefully. Okay, now the lower surface, this lower surface, this here, we already did it. So we will just extend the line up, extend the line up, and see where they will touch, and it's finished. So where is the lower surface? It's here, here, and here. So if I extend the line up, and it's already finished. This one to the vanishing point, we know it, and this already is complete here. And this is the first edge. Let me draw it again, because it's deleted from the overcrowding. Okay. So, our object is complete. As I said, the only thing is I added another 2 cubes on top, so remove them. You need to have 5 only. And that's it. Now here it looks too overcrowded and some lines you cannot really see, but this is because we are drawing with these pens. When you draw, please, very light pencil, okay? Only when you finish, when you complete the drawing and you are happy with the result, then you can draw heavier lines on the object, okay? And leave all these construction lines, you leave them. All of these I want to see. Don't delete. Okay. So don't delete anything, because I need to see how you construct it. And it will be much cleaner, much better on your paper. when you draw with the ruler. Okay, just make sure you do it step by step, as I explained. And as we followed each point, now you know what it means, okay? So you apply. You apply in the same order, and everything should be fine. Leave this cube, the middle one, for the last, okay? For the last. So you first build this cube, the big one, then build these. Always you start in the bottom, this row and this row. I said it before, always start at the bottom, two rows. Then put the objects on top, and then find objects from the back. And if you have difficult objects like these, for example, somewhere in the middle or in a strange space, hidden somewhere, okay? Then you draw these. And this method is very simple in one thing, that you can find any point on the object by here, by the corners, locate the corner to the SP point, then find where it intersects, straight line, and you know where it's located here. The rest is vanishing points, and see which lines intersect with which lines, and continue. So there should be no difficulty if you follow this procedure. Later in the future, especially if you're an interior designer, you will have so many objects to draw like these, okay? And much more difficult. But the same procedure you will follow. Also in industrial design, you need it. So, this method will be used a lot, as well as method A. Method A and B, very important. Okay, so this is it for today. Let me here, put this here, top view, okay, from the top. Okay, so this is it for today. Thank you for watching, and I hope it's clear what I explained. Your homework, as I said, will be this. You need to draw this object in scale 1:1. Okay, thank you.